Are there any tasks around your home that you're responsible for to keep it running smoothly, like washing the dishes or vacuuming? These tasks aren't always fun, but they serve an important purpose that helps everyone in your home live more comfortably. Other living things perform important tasks in their environment as well. Different living things contribute in different ways to create vibrant ecosystems, rich in resources that help all the organisms that live there. In today's lesson, we'll be exploring the organization of living things as well as their roles as we describe the structure and importance of populations and communities and explain the three main ecological roles of the organisms that contribute to them. Let's get into it. All living things are made of one or more cells. If you recall from a previous lesson, organisms are divided into specific groups called species, which can mate with each other to produce fertile offspring, like this red fox. A population is a group of organisms from the same species that live in an area at the same time. For example, all the red foxes that interact within an ecosystem form a population. These come together to create a community, which is made up of all the populations of different species that live in an area and interact with each other. Depending on the area, this could include a variety of plants, bacteria, protists, fungi, and animals. Then, when you take this community of living things and add abiotic factors like the land, air, and water, you get an ecosystem. Ecosystems come together to create biomes, which in turn make up the whole biosphere. Wow, we just went all the way from cells to every living thing in their environment. That's a lot of layers, but this organization of living things is important. By categorizing species into populations, we can study the characteristics and behaviors of specific groups of organisms in a particular area, like a group of wolves in Yellowstone National Park. This helps us understand how these populations change over time. Additionally, studying communities or groups of interacting populations gives us a broader view of the interactions between different species. For example, we can study how different species compete for resources, such as food and habitat, or how they cooperate with each other. Okay, so we've talked about populations and communities and why they're important. But what is it that living things actually do within their communities? To answer this question, we need to discuss ecological roles. An ecological role is a job that is performed by an organism within its habitat, or the environment in which it lives. Just like members of a family perform various responsibilities within a house to keep it running smoothly, like preparing dinner or taking out the trash, living things have their own responsibilities that help maintain their habitats. There are three main roles we'll be looking at in this lesson. And the first we'll discuss is the role of the producer. A producer makes or produces food for the ecosystem. This job is fulfilled by plants and similar organisms such as algae, which use the process of photosynthesis to create glucose or sugar out of water, carbon dioxide, and sunlight. Producers are absolutely essential because without them, there wouldn't be any food or energy available to the other organisms within an ecosystem. Producers also replenish oxygen in the air and are an important part of the water, carbon, and nitrogen cycles, helping to recycle these resources and keep them flowing through the ecosystem. This brings us to our next role, the consumer. A consumer eats or consumes other living things in order to obtain energy and food, since they can't make their own. There are several kinds of consumers. A herbivore is a type of consumer that only eats plants. Some examples are rabbits or deer. A carnivore is a type of consumer that only eats meat, such as a wolf or an owl. There are also some animals called omnivores that eat both plants and animals. Some examples of these are bears and raccoons. Consumers are important because through the process of cellular respiration, they help regulate the amount of oxygen, water, and carbon dioxide within the environment. Additionally, by eating other living things, They help control the population of both producers and other consumers to maintain balance within an ecosystem. For example, when wolves disappeared from Yellowstone National Park in the 1900s, the elk that was their natural prey became overpopulated, eating too many plants and disrupting the entire ecosystem. The final role we'll discuss is the role of the decomposer. Decomposers are organisms that break down or decompose dead organic matter. In our household analogy, these guys take out the trash, or to be more accurate, they completely break down the trash so it can turn into something brand new. Examples of decomposers are bacteria, fungi, and some insects, such as flies. Decomposers are important for fertilizing the soil and recycling nutrients, such as carbon, nitrogen, and phosphorus, so they can be reabsorbed by plants. Additionally, decomposers maintain balance within an ecosystem by preventing a buildup of waste materials in the environment. And with that, we have wrapped up our lesson covering communities of living things and their roles. We've learned that a population is a group of organisms from the same species that live in an area at the same time. From here, populations come together to create communities of multiple species. Then, when communities are combined with abiotic factors like water and air, it creates ecosystems. Populations and communities are important for understanding how individuals and groups interact and change over time. Finally, we covered the ecological roles of individuals within communities. A producer, such as a plant, makes food using photosynthesis. A consumer eats other living things to obtain food. And a decomposer breaks down and recycles dead organic matter. All of these roles are important for maintaining a healthy, balanced ecosystem. In our next lesson, we'll be diving deeper into ecology as we examine how ecological roles interact together to create food chains. Until then, I'm Anthony, and remember, life is full of wonders, so keep learning and don't ever stop wondering. Hey, hey.